Hello student, welcome back. This is Vasant Naik from Vostech channel. Today we will see one more instruction, SBB, subtract with borrow. We have seen SUB instruction. In the SUB instruction, if the carry flag is 0, then SBB works like SUB. If the carry flag is 1, then SBB subtracts 1 from the final result. You see here, in this case, you can see in this case, so here two word I have taken, double data I have taken, means double data means two words I have taken here. So I am going to subtract from one from the other. So SUB, I am using SUB. So first I am moving first word to AX, then I am subtracting AX with the second word. You may ask, what is this? You may ask here, what is this word PTR? So word PTR is, see here, you have defined here double data, but while working, it will not work. Computer will take, because 8086 is 16 bit. It can take only 16 bit data at a time. Here, while defining, you have defined double data. So you are telling the assembler, even though defined data is different, take it as a 16 bit at a time. That is the meaning of the word pointer. By using pointer directive, you will tell the assembler, take this as a word. So even though it is defined double data, you take this as a word. That means it will take at a time 16 bit at a time, and it will do the subtraction, and the result is also stored in one more location. Result also declared as double data, but it will store at a time 16 bit data. So result also you have defined a word by using pointer PTR. Now after that, move the second portion of the word, second portion of the data. So here you can see move second portion of the data, and SBB, if there is a carry, SBB will subtract 1 from the result, otherwise SBB works like SUB, and the final result is stored here. So now very important, what is pointer PTR? Pointer is a data directive used to specify the size of the operand when it differs from the defined size. In the example, word PTR tells the assembler to use word operand even though data is defined as a double word. I told you the data is defined as a double word, but it will tell the word pointer, will tell the assembler, use it as a word. You may ask why, because our registers are 16 bit, it cannot take double data at a time, so use it as a word. So that is the meaning of the pointer. So in the exam, they will ask what is pointer. This is the answer for pointer. Multiplication. So multiplication of the unsigned numbers. In the multiplication of the unsigned numbers, there are three category: byte into byte, word into word, and byte into word. So multiplication. So for multiplication, so 8 into 8 bit multiplication results in 16 bit in worst case. So AL and into BL, you have to store the result in AX. 16 into 16 may result in 32 bit. That time AX and BX, you have to store the result in AX and DX. So you are using two registers of 16 bit here. So you have to remember this table for multiplication. This table is very important, and in this table, once again, I'll repeat. You need to write this one. So if you are getting confused, this one and this one, write this one where the result is stored. You can skip these two operands and you can write this one, multiplication. And if possible, you give one example how it will multiply. So next one is division. Division, byte by byte, word by word, word divided by word, word divided by byte, and double word divided by word. So when you divide 8 bit by 8 bit, quotient is stored in AL and remainder is stored in AH. When you divide 16 bit, quotient is stored in AX, remainder is stored in DX. We are taking two numbers in AX by BX, and result is something like this. When you divide 16 bit by 8 bit, quotient is stored in AL and remainder is stored in. When you divide 32 by 16, quotient is stored in AX and remainder is stored in DX. Please remember this one. Along with this one, you have to remember here. You have to remember here also. You have to remember this table. This table is required. This table, in this table, this and how the quotient and results are stored, one and same. What I explained now, this is required. Other than that, one example is always necessary. You can see here one example. When I divide word by byte, I will take first word in AX, second one is CL. Division CL, D-I-V-C-L. Please remember, in multiplication and division, first operand is always accumulator. Here also, first operand is always accumulator. You need not to write. If you write MUL AX into CL wrong, MUL CL, it will take AX automatically. In division also, division CL, it will divide AX with CL. You should not write DIV AX, CL, that is wrong. So please remember this one. So here result is moved into this one. So after this, we have logical instruction. In the exam, they will ask what is logical instruction, AND or XOR, shift and compare. These are the logical instruction you have to explain. First, you have to explain AND instruction. So take one data in BL register and that data with 0F. So what is the use of AND? You have to write this statement. AND can be used to mask certain bits. Clearing the bit in the binary number is called as masking. You can write this one. Clearing the bit in binary number is called as masking. So for example, here this is unknown bit number and this is the known number. You are ANDing it. Now wherever 0 is there, the unknown number, that part of the unknown number, whatever it may be, it becomes 0. Wherever 0 is there, that part of the unknown number becomes 0. You are going to mask it. That is AND operation. So now next, OR operation. OR operation, similarly, you can take one value in the register and you can use OR. And you can write OR operation used to set certain bits to 1. For example, here you can see I am taking unknown number and this I will OR with this number. Wherever 1 is there, irrespective of the number becomes 1. Wherever 1 is there, irrespective of the number becomes, in the result, the number becomes 1. You can see a number becomes 1. So you can write OR can be used to set certain bits of the operand to 1. So that is OR. After that, we have something called as exclusive OR. We know exclusive OR, 00. Here it is given wrong, 00001110110. So you have to take two numbers and you have to show the operation of the exclusive OR. So next one is after exclusive OR, the next one is a shift. We have shift instructions, so that I will explain in the next video.